Good morning. Let us start the next session on information theory and coding. Let us get introduced to block codes. In the last class, we spoke about what is channel coding or error control coding, why we need to do it, or what is the rationale for error control coding, and how it is actually done. What is the difference between source coding and channel coding? What are the different techniques to do channel coding? All this we saw. Now, let's come to analyze the first set of channel codes, also known as block codes. These block codes, in general, operate on a block of bits, a group or block of bits. And they basically make use of a preset algorithm. So it's a well-known algorithm which they are going to use, and they will try to add a code to a group of data bits. Say I have a data bit group of 4 bits. To that I'll add 3 more bits, and I'm going to increase the size of the data block. Okay, that group of 4 bits is 1 data block. To that, if I add 3 more bits, I'm going to increase the size of the data block. We said we are going to add redundancy here. And those added bits are mainly used for error detection and correction. So this block is then checked at the receiver. After it is transmitted, it will be checked at the receiver, and the receiver will validate the sequence. The receiver will see how this sequence should be used. Okay. Block codes are usually written in the form n, k. So we normally write it in the form n, k block code, where n represents the number of bits in the code word and k represents the number of bits in the message or data word, we call it as. We call the basic message word or data word. Okay. One second. Yeah. So block codes are usually written in this form, n, k. N represents number of bits in the code word. K represents number of bits in the message or the data word. To generate an n, k block code, the channel encoder accepts information in k successive bit blocks. So in blocks of k bits, it's going to accept the message. Every message will be k bits in length, and it's going to accept multiple messages, convert each message to an n bit code word. Okay. And for each block, it's going to add n minus k redundant bits. So it will be adding n minus k redundant bits to produce an encoded block of n bits called as code word. So code word will be of n bits in length. Data word or message word will be k bits in length. Please remember that. And the additional n minus k bits which are added to the data are known as checked bits or parity bits. So we call these additional n minus k bits as check or parity bits. They are redundant or extra bits which we are going to add to the message. Okay. So the n minus k redundant bits are algebraically related to the k message bits. How we are going to get those redundant bits? It's not that we arbitrarily choose some bits. We have to form some kind of algebraic relationship between those check or parity bits, the redundant bits which we add, and the original message bits or the data bits. Okay. And the channel encoder produces bits at a rate called as channel data rate R0. The channel data rate would be N by K into RS. RS represents the source data rate. So it is the rate at which the data input comes to the channel encoder. N is the number of output bits of the channel encoder. K is the number of input bits. K represents number of bits in the data or message. N represents the number of bits in the code. Okay. So information is divided into blocks of length K. However large your information, you're going to divide it into smaller blocks, each of length K. To that, you will add R parity bits, or we say N minus K parity bits. So if the message size is K bits and if the code word has to be N bits, the extra bits, N minus K bits, are known as parity bits or checked bits. As I told you, they are called parity or checked bits. And rather than R, let us keep it as N minus K itself. Okay. They are added to each block. The code rate of the encoder would be K by N. So K is the input bits, N is the output bits. And why do we call them as linear block codes? We call the block codes as linear if the vector sum of two code words is another code word which belongs to the same code. What's the meaning of this statement? Let's just see. Say I have one code word C1, which is 011010. This belongs to a code C. I have another code word C2, which is 101101. This also belongs to the same code word C. Now, if I perform the vector sum C1 plus, here we do everything in modulo 2, as I'm going to tell you a little later. So if I do C1 added to C2 using modulo 2 addition, what will I get? I'm going to get 1, 1, 1. 1 plus 1 is a 0. Okay. And 1 plus 0 is a 1. So what am I going to get? I'm going to get 1110111. And whatever I'm going to get, this should also be, this corresponds to another code C3 or whatever in the same code word C. So there is a code word C which has a set of codes C1, C2, C3, so on. It can have a set of codes. And if I take any two code words in this code and do a vector sum or a addition, simple addition, it will result in a third code word which will also belong to the same code C. This is known as a linear block code. Only if this property is satisfied, we call it as a linear block code. And all the block codes which we study, the initial block codes, are all linear in nature. So there will always be trade-offs between the efficiency of coding, the reliability, as well as the complexity. So everything doesn't come easy. You always have trade-offs between these factors. And as I told you before, all arithmetic is performed using mod 2 addition. Okay. So how do we perform modulo 2 operation? Encoding and decoding functions will involve binary arithmetic operation of mod 2. The rules for mod 2 operations are, in addition, 0 plus 0 would result in a 0. 1 plus 0 or 0 plus 1 would result in 1s. 1 plus 1 would be a 0. So please remember this. Modulo 2 is similar to XOR operation. We are all familiar with XOR gate. So this modulo 2 operation is similar to this XOR. Okay. Then modulo 2 multiplication also. Anything multiplied with a 0 is 0. Only when I multiply 1 with a 1, I'm going to get a 1. So this is modulo 2 multiplication and modulo 2 addition. We'll be working with mod 2 operation, or we work in a Galois field 2, GF2 we call it as. We are going to work in GF2, and the operations are addition and multiplication. The two operations which we are, two means which has only two values, zeros and ones. We'll be working with binary data and over two operators using either addition or multiplication, okay, throughout this these two modules. Now, coming to linear block codes. So the actual data or the uncoded data, which are k bits size block, it's a block of k bits in length, is represented either as a message vector m1, m2, mk, or we can write it as the data vector d1, d2, so on, dk. This is a much more common representation. Either write it as m1, m2, mk, or d1, d2, dk. Some books use u1, u2, uk. Anything will do, okay? As long as you know what it represents. The corresponding code word can be represented by the code vector c1, c2, so on up to ck. Then I'll have ck plus 1, ck plus 2, so on till cn. Remember, the code vector is it's a n-bit vector, right? We call it as a n-bit vector. It is what? A row vector. Similarly, the data vector is a k-bit vector. So this is a k-bit vector. It is a row, one row vector we are going to call. It has one row of data. Okay? And when I represent in binary, it will either be in the form of ones and zeros, something like this. Even this, 1, 1, 0, 1, whatever I want, I can have just ones and zeros. Okay. So in this, actually for a k-bit word size, we are getting extra n minus k bits in the code vector. So they are called parity bits or check bits, as I told you before. Every parity bit is constructed as a weighted modulo 2 sum of the data bits, which is normally represented by this symbol. Modulo 2 operation is usually represented with a plus symbol covered with a circle. So each and every check bit here, say CK plus 1 will be, I'll write it as P11 into D1 plus P12 into D2, so on. It will be represented as a weighted modulo 2 sum. All this is a modulo. Though we'll write simply plus, please understand it's always modulo 2 here. Okay. So each parity bit, this is a parity bit now. The bit after the data size is k bits. The bit after the data size, k plus 1, k plus 2, are all parity or check bits or the redundant bits. Each one is going to be represented as a weighted modulo 2 sum of the data bits, and it is represented by this mod 2 symbol, plus symbol, which indicates modulo 2 addition or XOR operation. Okay. So linear block codes are normally constructed in the systematic form where the information bits will remain unchanged and the parity bits will be attached either in the beginning or in the end. So you see how the code word is formed in this. You can clearly see the first k bits of the code word are same as the message. So C1 is M1, C2 is M2, so on. The first k bits of the code word are same as the message. The next n minus k bits, these n minus k check bits are formed using linear combination of the message or the data with the parity bits. So there are many ways in which I can write this parity words or the parity bits. In this, it is represented like this. So these check bits are formed using what? A weighted modulo 2 addition of the message and the parity bits. So the parity bits are multiplied with the message and then they are added using modulo 2 addition or XOR operation. So this is how we are going to generate n bit code word. Okay. See, alternatively, we can write it. I told you in some textbooks, they'll write the data as U. Here, data is represented as U1, so on. U2, it's a K bit data vector. And the code is represented here as V1, V2, so on till Vn. Remember, it is a N bit code vector. So if I want to represent these things in the form of a matrix, it becomes very simple. You see the linear equation formed. Initially, the code bit is equal to data bit. V1 is equal. This is same as telling C1 is equal to M1, C2 is equal to M2, whatever we wrote in the previous equation here. The same thing, only the representation is different. So the first K bits of the code word are same as the data word. The K plus 1th code bit is a weighted modulo 2 sum of parity multiplied with data, as you can see. Okay, where P11, P21, P31 are all called parity bits. So here the parity bits, this P11, P21, each of these are parity bits, P12, so on, and P1 n minus k. Then I'll have P22, P2 n minus k, so on, PK1, PK2, PK n minus k. All these are parity bits, data bits, code bits, parity bits. And parity or check bits multiplied with the data bits and combined linearly using some addition, modulo 2 addition, generates the check bits or the redundant bits. The redundant or check bits are generated using such linear equations. You should be able to write these equations. Now, all analysis is made very simple if we can express each of these in terms of a matrix rather than writing it as a vector. Say, this data is a what? 1 cross k vector. It has 1 row, k columns. This code is a 1 cross n vector, 1 row, n columns, right? And this parity is a matrix of size k cross n minus k. There are k elements or k rows in the parity matrix and n minus k columns. Remember, I have to add n minus k redundant bits in every data word to make it a code word. Each and every data word should get n minus k redundant bits. So this parity matrix will have, as you can see, it has k rows, and n minus k columns. Okay. So you see, we have represented each one here. How will I write the expression for the code? So I can simply say the code word V1, V2 till Vn, which is of order 1 cross n, is obtained by multiplying the data word of order 1 cross k with something like this. I have here an identity matrix. This is an identity matrix. As you can see, 1 followed with 0, 0, 1, so on. And to this identity matrix, we have appended something known as the parity matrix. So the parity matrix and identity matrix are appended and put together. Whenever I multiply this, you can multiply and see here. U1 into 1, what will I get? See, here the first bit, V1, is equal to U1 into 1, plus U2 into 0, whatever, so on till UK into 0. What's the value here? V1 would be equal to U1. Yes or no? So V1 is equal to U1. Similarly, V2 will be equal to U2. So on VK will be equal to UK. Okay. So when I multiply this data vector with the identity matrix, I will get this first line of the equation. V1 is U1, V2 is U2, V3 is U3, VK is UK. Next, when I multiply this data vector with this parity matrix, you'll get the next line. You see VK plus 1, this bit is U1 into P11 plus U2 into P21. Remember, matrix multiplication is row into column. I should take this row and multiply it into this column. So U1 into P11 plus U2 into P21 plus U3 into P31, so on, plus UK into PK1. Okay, we have multiplied. Similarly, I'll get the first check bit or the first redundant or parity bit. Similarly, the next redundant or parity bit is obtained by multiplying this row with the second column. So when I multiply this row with the second column, I'll get the second line in this or the next check bit. And likewise, the nth check bit or n minus k check bit is obtained when I multiply this data vector with the last column in the parity matrix. So this matrix which we have written here, which has an identity matrix of order k and a parity matrix of order k cross n minus k, is known very important matrix. It is called the generator matrix. So a generator matrix is one which is formed using the concatenation of an identity matrix with a parity matrix. And this parity matrix is very important in calculating the check bits. And writing the whole vectors, the data vector, code vector, and parity vector, everything as a matrix will make it easy for us. So you can see, how do I write this equation? You can write the equation V is equal to U into G, where U is the data matrix, G is the generator matrix, and V is the code matrix. Actually, V and U are simple vectors, row vectors. Or if I call the code as C, I can say C is equal to, if I call the data as D, C is equal to D into G. So these are two ways in which we can represent the matrix. So linear block codes are those where an n-bit code word can be formed from a k-bit message, by systematically adding, n minus k check bits, check or parity bits. So in linear block codes, we have linear equations defining the code bits. We can say if C bits represent code and D represents data. So all C's represent the code bits and D represent the data bits. Then we have C1 is equal to D1, C2 is equal to D2, C3 is equal to D3. We could also call the data bits as M1, M2, M3, message bits, and so on. CK is equal to DK, and CK plus 1 is equal to P11, D1, P21, D2, so on until PK1DK, and finally CN is P1N-K D1, P2N-K D2, PKN-KDK. So we could represent the relation between all the data bits and the code bits as linear equations. They are simple linear equations used to define the relationship between code word and data word. Here, the P values are parity or the check bits. The P are parity or check bits. And we also spoke that this equation can be standardized and represented in matrix form as C is equal to D into G, where D represents the data matrix of order 1 cross K. So it is a row vector having K bits. And C is the code matrix of order 1 cross N, 1 row, N columns, N bit code word. And G is known as the generator matrix. And this generator matrix is of size K cross N, K rows and N columns. And we also wrote the standard form of this. So we could write C as C1, C2, so on till CN, and D, the data vector is D1, D2 till DK, and the generator matrix can be written as 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, followed with all zeros, so on. Last row will have all zeros followed with 1. So this represents an identity matrix of order K. And following this, I have to append the parity matrix P11, P12, so on, P1, N minus K. Similarly, P21, P22, P2, N minus K. And here, PK1, PK2, PKN minus K. So this completes the matrix, and this we are going to give the standard representation as the code matrix is equal to data matrix into generator matrix. So this represents the generator, which is formed using the identity matrix and the parity matrix. We call this part, the piece, as a parity matrix. Okay. And now coming to the standard representation of G, G can either be written as identity followed with parity, or it can also be written as parity first followed with identity. Okay, if it is written in the form of identity matrix first followed by parity, then the first K bits will be same, code bits will be same as data. The first K code bits will be same as the data, and these N minus K bits will be your parity or check bits. Whereas if we write it in this form, the last K bits will be data. The last K code bits will be same as data. The first N minus K bits will be your parity or check bits. So in any one of the forms we can represent, and the code word so obtained using this technique is called systematic. It's called a systematic linear block code. The name systematic is mainly because we have a clear distinction between the data bits and the check bits. So whenever there is a clear separation between data and check bits, we call it as a systematic code. Very often what happens, there will be a merger of data and check bits. You won't be able to identify what is what. In that case, we call it as a non-systematic code. Now, coming to the example, let us consider one simple example of this linear block code. Find the linear block code generator G if the parity bits are determined as C5 is equal to M1 plus M3 plus M4, C6 M1 plus M2 plus M4, C7 M1 plus M2 plus M3 for a 7,4 code. So the standard representation of linear block code, we said, is in the form N, K. It is in the form of N, K, and this 7,4 code is given. N represents the total number of bits in the code word, that is 7, and K represents the total number of bits in the data word, which is 4. The number of parity bits will surely be 7 minus 4, which is 3. So how do we write the parity matrix given this equation? The linear equations, as we discussed in the previous slides, are given. You see, the equations are in this form. Here, the P's are either ones or zeros. I told you the alternate way of writing D is message, M1, M2, M3. Wherever I have D, I can also put M. Okay? So the equation given for us is in this form. Ck plus 1 is P11D1, so on. That's the given equation from which I have to first construct a parity matrix. So how will you construct a parity matrix based on this equation? Naturally, if you remember, in matrix multiplication, we multiply a given row of the first matrix with a column of the second matrix. So this equation will come in that form. If at all, let me show you in this. Say, if I have an equation in this form, say D into this, you can easily say the first one, D1, here C1 will be D1 into 1 plus D2 into 0, so on till DK into 0. Likewise, after writing everything, if I am interested in writing the value of a code bit CK plus 1, after completion of K bits, the next bit if I want to write, again, it's the same multiplication. D1 into what? D1 into P11, this one, this column I have to consider now, this column, plus D2 into P21, so on, DK into PK1. Remember, D and M are same. So what is the meaning of this? A column into this will tell us, will give us the equation, linear equation for the code bit. Now, if I am given the linear equation, say I am given the equation in the form M1 plus M2 plus M3 for C5, what does this mean? This correspondingly means the column, the first column of the parity matrix should have a 1 in the first place because this is present. M2 is also present, so a 1 here. M3 is also present, so another 1 here. But M4 is absent, so this will be a 0. So if I have a 7,4 code, I will construct the parity matrix based on the check bits. The values given here are called check bits. So C5 is the first check bit, and that first check bit can be constructed by looking into these positions along the column. The first column is made up of M1, so a high here. M3, so M2 is not there, put a 0 in the second place. M3 is there, put a high. M4 is there, make a 1. Next, the second check bit C6 is defined as M1 plus M2 plus M4. M3 is not there. Okay. And C7 is defined as M1 plus M2 plus M3. And M4 is not there. So this is a 0. Now, please remember for a 7,4 code, okay, the parity matrix will be of size K cross N minus K. So what is K here? K is 4, N minus K is 3. So I should construct a parity matrix of size 4 cross 3, which I have obtained from the three linear equations defining the three check bits C5, C6 and C7. So hope you understood how to write this matrix. So based on the data bit values in the equation, I have to construct columns of the parity matrix. Now we have to write the generator matrix. So the generator matrix is defined in the form identity matrix appended with the parity matrix. For this 7,4 code, the generator matrix should have I4, K value is 4, and the parity matrix is of size 4 cross 3. So I have written a K-bit identity matrix in the first place, followed with the parity matrix which we obtained here. Okay. So in this problem, we are finding the value of the generator matrix first. Next, you are supposed to find the various code vectors. So given the code, see, C is equal to M into G, or it can be D into G. Anything you can use. Either D into G or M into G, any one of the things. Now, with a 4-bit message, the K value is 4. How many possible message combinations do we have? We can have 2 to the power of 4 or 16 possible messages. And to find the code vectors, we have to multiply these message bits considering M1, M2, M3, M4 with the generator matrix to get the code bits. It is easier if we represent this multiplication in the form of equation. If not, for each combination of data word, you have to just go on substituting the data word and go on multiplying every time. Say the first data word will be all zeros, 4-bit combinations. I'll have 16 different 4-bit combinations, all zeros to all ones. So you can take each individual combination, multiply it with this generator matrix and get the value of the code word. That is one option. The other option is you write the equation using the values M1, M2, M3, M4 for the data bits. Okay. Or D1, D2, D3, D4. It's optional. Here, the first code bit, we know C is comprising of bits from C1 to C7. The first code bit C1 is equal to M1. C2 will be same as M2 and C3, M3, C4, M4. The first four code bits will be same as the data bits. The fifth code bit we are already given. It is M1 plus M3 plus M4. The sixth code bit is M1 plus M2 plus M4. See, it is simple matrix multiplication. M1 into 1 plus M2 into 1 plus M3 into 0 plus M4 into 1. So I'll get this equations easily. The first four message bits will just be passed on directly as code bits. For the remaining parity bits, which are used for error detection and correction, they are the additional redundant bits which we will add to the message to enable error detection and correction. They are calculated as a linear combination of data bits. So C5, the first check bit, is obtained as M1 plus M3 plus M4. Then C6 is M1, M2, M4, C7, M1, M2, M3. So if we write these equations, it would be easy for us to determine all the data vectors. So how do you determine all the data vectors? You make a table like this. Okay. So in this table, you are just going to write the data vector to the left, and to the right, we will write the code vector. And to write the code vector, I'm going to list all the equations. C1 is M1, C2, M2, C3, C4 are M3 and M4. C5, M1 plus M3 plus M4. C6, M1, M2, M4. C7, M1, M2, M3. And remember, all additions here are modulo 2 additions or XOR operations. So if you have the four data bits as all zeros, the code bits, the first four code bits will remain the same, all zeros. And the last three also will be all zeros, because adding zeros to themselves will retain the zero. Now, the next code bits are 0001. The first four next data bits are 0001. The first four code bits will remain as 0001. To calculate C5, I should add M1 with M3 and M4. 0 plus 0. So this plus this plus this, which will give you 1. So you see C5 is a 1. C6 is M1 plus M2 plus M4. M1, M2, M4, again a 1. And C7 is M1, M2, M3. M1, M2, M3 are all zeros. Therefore, C7 is a 0. Likewise, if I have to calculate the code for the data, I'm listing this in sequence. All zeros, then 1, then 2. So now the data bits are 0010. Okay. So now the data bits are 0010. And the first four code bits will remain the same. 0010. And C5 will be M1, M3, M4, which will be a 1. C6 is M1, M2, M4, which will be a 0. C7 is M1, M2, M3. When I add, I'm going to get a 1. So I hope you understood. It would be very easy to write all the data vectors one after the other by listing all sequence of data and finding the corresponding code vectors using these linear equations. So likewise, you go on finding for all values 0011, and it's very easy also. The first four bits will remain same as the data. So if I have 0011, the first four bits will remain 0011, because your generator matrix is in the form identity followed by parity. Okay. Now, the fifth bit will be M1, M3, M4, where is 1 plus 1 is a 0. The sixth bit will be M1, M2, M4, which will be a 1. And the seventh bit will be M1, M2, M3, which will be a 1. So likewise, I can go on listing for all the 16 possible combinations. The last combination we'll do, it is all ones. Okay, 0011, 0100. For each value, we can go on listing. The last combination is an all one. So which can be written as 1111. And here, if you notice, everywhere we have three data bits. And since all the data bits are one, whenever I add odd number of ones, your answer remains a one. So you can blindly fill one here, because I have three data bits added using XOR or modulo 2 operation in each of these. Okay. So this is how we will construct the code table using for a given linear block code. So I told you the other way of doing it is to take each message vector or data vector. Say I want to find for 0100. Sorry. Okay. If I want to find for 0100, the code word. This 0100 will be multiplied with the generator. One, we know what is the generator matrix, 0011, and the parity matrix M1, M3, M4, M1, M2, correct? What was the given value? M1, M2, M4, and M1, M2, M3. This was the given value. I want to show you the alternate way of computing the code vector. You have to do matrix multiplication here. So whenever the first four bits, you need not worry, because whenever I'm going to multiply any data with an identity matrix, remember, this is an identity matrix. So please remember, this should be identity matrix I4. Multiplication of anything with identity will give you the same value. What you should worry about is multiplication of this with the parity matrix. So if I take this first column, if I take this first column with this row, it will give me what? 0 into 1 is a 0. 1 into 0 is a 0. 0 into 1 is again a 0. 0 into 1 is a 0. So addition of all zeros will result in a 0. Next, you just have to observe the matching positions of ones. See, I have a single one in this data vector, and you scan this column and see if there is a one in the same corresponding position. So this is second position. In the second position, I have a one, and all other positions, since this is zero, I will get 0 plus 1 plus 0 plus 0, which will result in a 1. That's all you need to do. Again, this row into the last column. So again, observe the second position. Is the second position having a 1? Yes. The remaining positions don't matter to us because they are 0 in the data vector. So only if the second position is a 1, your answer will be a 1. And this will be the corresponding code vector for the data or message vector 0100. So this is another alternate way of finding code vectors for individual code words. Then you can take 0101 and again multiply with the generator matrix. You'll get 0101 followed by 3 bits. So you go on doing this, you'll be able to calculate either using this way or using this way. Through equations, it seems much simpler and easy. Once you write the relation, you just have to add those particular data bits and find the check bits C5, C6, C7. It would be faster. Anyway, that depends. So there are many ways of writing this code vector. So given a linear block code and given the size of the linear block code, you can find the code vector in any format. For example, you are given a 6, 3, given 6, 3 linear block code with, say, parity matrix as 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. Say this is given, and they ask you to construct all possible code vectors. Construct all possible code vectors. How would we do it? First step is to write the generator matrix. How do I write the generator matrix? Normally, identity matrix followed with parity matrix. Now, what should be the size of this? What should be the size of the generator, since it is a 6, 3 code? N is 6, K is 3. So the order of generator matrix is K cross N, which will be 3 cross 6. So I should write an identity matrix of order 3 first. 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. This is our identity matrix. Now you append the parity matrix given to the identity, then it makes the generator. So these two combined together is your G matrix or the generator matrix. It is done. Now, how do you find all possible code vectors? You just have to write linear equations, I told you. So you can make this table. You can make a table. Yeah. In this table, first I list out the message bits. Let me call it D1, D2, D3. It will be a 3-bit message here. Yes or no? Because the K size is 3, I'm going to have a 3-bit message. Next, I will list out the code word and I'll write it in equation form directly. Now, C1, the first code bit. Remember, this is how do I get the C? It is D1, D2, D3 into G. So for example, I'll consider D1, D2, D3 here and I multiply C1, the first code bit, C1 to C6. I'm going to have 6 code bits. C1 will be equal to D1. C2 will be equal to D2. See, it's an identity matrix. So the first 3 bits of code word will be same as data. C3 will be same as D3. Now the question comes, what would C4 be? C4 would be the multiplication of this row D1, D2, D3 with this particular column 1, 1, 1. So what would I get as the equation? D1 plus D2 plus D3. So you would get this as the equation for the first check bit C4 as D1 plus D2 plus D3. The next check bit C5 would be D2 plus D3. And the last check bit C6 would be D1 plus D3. So we have the linear equations for all the complete code word written. Now, you just go on listing the various combination of data and accordingly you will be obtaining the corresponding code word. So for all zeros, we know the code word will also have all zeros because there is no one anywhere. For 001, the first 3 bits should be same 001. Then what should I do? I should add all the 3 bits D1 plus D2 plus D3, which will give me 1. Next, you add D2 and D3, which will also give you a 1. Then you add D1 and D3, which will also give you a 1. So the check bits in the second case are 1, 1, 1. Likewise, you go on finding for all cases and the last one is all high. So when everything is high, the first 3 bits again will indicate all 1s. The fourth bit will be sum of 3 ones, which will again be a 1. The fifth bit will be sum of 2 ones, which would be a 0. In XOR or modulo 2 addition, 1 plus 1 is a 0. We saw that. And sixth bit will also be sum of 2 bits, which will be a 0. So this is how we can design a linear block code. Okay, a code word can be designed in this format. So let's stop with this and I'll continue with encoder circuit in the next class.